In this video, I will show you how to check if the date is a working day in Excel like this. So let's get started. In this Excel sheet, I have some dates in this column. Now I want to check if each of these dates is a working day or a holiday. To do that, we can use the workday function. The workday function returns the nearest working day in the past or future corresponding to the specified date. This function accepts three arguments: a start date, a number of days to add or remove, and a third optional holiday. A positive value of the second number of days argument gives us a future working day date, and a negative value gives us the past working day date. To check if the date is a working day or holiday, I am going to use this function. Here is the formula to do that. Here I have specified the previous day of the date as the first start date argument. Since dates are stored as serial numbers in Excel, we can simply get the previous day of the date by subtracting 1 from it using the minus sign. I have specified 1 as the second number of days argument. It will add 1 day to the date we specified as the first argument. I have then compared the output date with the original date to check if the dates match. In short, this formula checks if the date is a working day by adding 1 working day to the previous day of the date. If the date is a working day, when we add 1 working day to the previous day, we get the same original date. If the date is a holiday, when we add 1 working day to the previous day, we will not get the same date back. Let's press the Enter key to complete the formula. Copy the formula to other cells by dragging the cell down from the bottom right corner of the cell. As you can see, we got true values for the dates that are working days and false for the dates that are holidays. By default, the workday function considers only Saturday and Sunday as weekends. The rest of the days are considered as working days. To include the public holidays as well, we can provide third holiday argument to the workday function. For example, here in this Excel sheet, I have specified the list of public holidays in this column. To take these holidays into account, we can specify this range of the cells as the third optional holiday argument. Let's modify the formula and include the holidays as well. As you can see, now the formula also takes the public holidays into account and returns the false value for the holiday dates. Watch these videos to learn more Excel tips, tricks, and how-to tutorials. If you found this video helpful, please like the video and subscribe to our channel.